Hi, this is Aileen from Materialise Belgium. In this tutorial video, we'll talk about generating support for metal printing in Materialise Magics. Metal printing, or metal powder bed fusion, is an additive manufacturing technology that involves melting metal powder by heating with a high power density laser. The metal powder bed fusion is a high temperature process with very rapid heating and cooling rates, and therefore, large residual stresses are created during the build. In order to minimize these stresses, the metal powder bed fusion technology requires support structures. Support structures primarily act as heat sinks and anchors for the parts. Supports are additional material that will be discarded after a build, and the supported areas need to be post-processed to improve surface quality. Therefore, it's important to have the tools to design supports that will be strong enough to anchor the part and will also be easy to remove after the build. In Magics, the tools to create support for metal come with the SG Plus module. I will use these tools in this tutorial. In Magics, the first step in support generation is setting up default support generation profiles. Just go to the Build Preparation ribbon, Machine Properties, and the Support Generation Parameters page on the pop-up window. Here, you can choose a general support profile for your machine. These can be used, for example, when you are working with different materials on the same machine. Also, you can select a support type. Non-solid supports are supports with no specific thickness assigned. The laser will make a single pass to create them. Volume, cones, and trees are called solid supports, and they have a specified thickness. As we're generating support for metal, let's enable block from non-solid supports. This means that when we click on Generate Support, the software will generate block supports only. Later on, we can change individual support types and settings from the support generation mode. We can set the default profile for block support here. The actual creation of the profile will happen in the support generation mode. You can have multiple profiles for a support type, and you can use the relevant profile for certain part geometries or processing parameters. Alternatively, you can load a profile from another machine. In this window, you can specify the self-supporting angle. In this case, it is 45 degrees. Let's apply these changes to our machine settings. We'll see more about the settings specific to block supports in the following steps. Before generating support, we'll briefly check the supported surfaces on our part. Let's go to the Support Generation ribbon, change to the bottom view, and click on Supported Area Preview. The colored regions are the surfaces that will be supported. If there are surfaces where you prefer not to have support, you can go back to the orientation tools and optimize your orientation at this point. If you'd like to learn more about modifying and optimizing the orientation for your part, please see our tutorial on the orientation tools in Magics. However, please note that part geometry is a limiting factor in part orientation and support generation. In other words, it's not always possible to completely avoid support on sensitive details, or a region that's unreachable to post-process for support removal. If there is no other solution, you can use the No Support Zone option for such a case. You only need to mark the region and click on Add No Support Zones. You will receive a warning. Click OK and add marked area in the following window. Please note that it is always a risk to not support a surface that's not self-supporting. You can always remove the no support zones by using the removal options in the same window. Let's remove the no support zone and continue to support generation. From the support generation ribbon, we'll click on generate support, and Magics will take us to the support generation mode. Here, we can see our list of supported surfaces, change the support type for a surface, and modify individual support parts. From the Support Parameters page, you can change the support type by just clicking on a different type. For each support type, there will be tabs with common and advanced settings, as well as settings specific to that support type. Let's stick with block supports and optimize it a little. We can start by the support piece which is touching another surface of the part. This will lead to more post-processing, so we would like to avoid this. We can go to Advanced from the Support Parameters page and enable Angle Support. Click on Interactive Angle and move the support away from the surface. With the vertical and inline angled support options, we can angle the support starting from the lowest point of the surface or directly from the connection to the part, respectively. I also want to increase the hatching frequency here to strengthen my support, so I'll decrease the hatch distance. To be able to recuperate powder more easily, I'll add some fragmentation to these hatches. I can even perforate the supports to further facilitate powder removal. At any time, I can save these settings as a support profile. Let's call this one Dense Hatch Fragment Perforate. Now I can use a support profile for other support surfaces with a single click. You can use solid supports, volume, cone, and tree as the main support type or as complementary to non-solid supports. For example, for a region with a large XY cross-section, I can add some manual cones to minimize build risks. And here's our part with supports. We can now continue to the following steps of 3D printing. Materialise also offers a fully automatic support generation solution to bridge the experience gap, called E-Stage. With E-Stage, you can minimize human error in support generation, reduce data preparation time, recover more powder, and save post-processing time. If you'd like to learn more about automatic support generation with E-Stage, please see our E-Stage tutorial. Thank you for watching, and please make sure you check our other tutorial videos. For further questions about our software, please don't hesitate to contact the support line of your nearest Materialise office.